What is up? Welcome back to my channel, GlamBySam. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. So if you clicked on this video, you either watch my videos, and for that, thank you so much, or you clicked on it because you want to start a YouTube channel. Because as you can read from the title, today's video is going to be my 10 tips on how to start a YouTube channel in 2020. And I really wanted to do this video because I feel like now everyone's at home. A lot of people want to start their channels, but they either like don't really know how to or they're scared. And I hope that with this video I can help you a bit. So I came up with 10 tips that are, in my opinion, I think one of the most important things about starting a YouTube channel. And in this video, I'll be sharing this with you guys. So if during this video you do happen to enjoy it, then I would love it if you gave it a thumbs up. And don't forget, you can always subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell if you want to see more videos. But without further ado, let's just get started with the 10 tips on how to start a YouTube channel in 2020. So the very first tip is, of course, when you start or create a channel, you need a username. And I feel like a username is really important because that is a thing people are going to notice and remember you by. I really recommend creating a name that you're not going to want to change later on, because that may get a little confusing, but also a name that's easy to remember for people and easy to type for people in the search bar. For instance, my real name is not actually Sam. My name is Dutch, and it's really difficult for not Dutch speakers to pronounce or know how to write. So that is why I went with my nickname Sam for this channel, because I feel like it's much more easy for people to remember and look up when they want to search for my videos. And to go along with that, I don't really recommend going with your last name, because that may give a little bit more private information that you don't want to share on the internet. I always think, like, I want my username, like, if someone were to tell their friends about my channel, like, you should really watch this girl's video, I want to have a name that, like, the friend can easily remember and search for. Because if you have a really, like, complicated name, like, they might make typos and they maybe won't find your channel, so that's something to avoid. So stick with an easy to remember and catchy name. Then my second tip is really important, that is good channel art. If you're just starting out and you want to make your channel like look more professional, channel art is a really nice way for this. And by channel art, I mean a banner, a profile picture, and thumbnails. And preferably, it would be nice to have them all in the same style and like the same vibe. So mine is like pink and fun. The banner goes with the intro for my video, and then it's also in the same style as my profile photo, and then all my thumbnails are pretty much all in the same style. Sometimes I do change like the colors a bit, but they're pretty much all in the same style. If any of you wants to see a video on how I edit my thumbnails, then I would love to do that. If you want to see that, you can always let me know in the comments, or if you have any questions regarding thumbnails or banners, you can always ask me. Then my third tip is have good lighting. People always think when they start out their channel that you need a really like professional good camera. But a lot of people don't realize that lighting is actually maybe even more important than a good camera. I film on a DSLR camera, which I'm very lucky to have. I've had this camera for 7 years now, so it's pretty long, but it's still working completely fine. It's the Canon EOS 600D or like the Rebel T3i. I believe it's like the same camera, but really, iPhones nowadays or other phones have really good quality cameras in them, but the one thing that's really important is lighting. Because you can have like a super professional, really expensive camera, but if your lighting isn't good or it's dark, it's not going to look nice. So what I film with right now, I have natural lighting coming in from the window, and then I have a softbox right there that basically helped me get that little bit of extra brightness that I want in my videos. I think natural lighting is really the best thing to have. Just make sure you don't film like in the evening when there's barely any light, because that's not going to look good. If you're really like dependent on filming in the evenings, maybe because of your work, then I do recommend studio lights, because if you have great studio lights, they can really make it look like it's bright outside. But if you have the opportunity to film during the day, I do recommend that, since natural lighting is always going to look the best. Then my fourth tip is, for if you have a DSLR camera, I do recommend investing in a second battery. The reason why I recommend this is because I don't know how many times I've had the experience where I wanted to film for instance 2 videos in a row because I was really like in the filming mood, but then like my battery died halfway during the second video, and then I had to wait for 2 hours or something until my battery was charged. Then the lighting was different, I looked different, I was like waiting all the time until my battery was charged, and it's just really annoying. An external battery for a DSLR is not the cheapest, but it's definitely not that expensive either, and it just really makes a difference because if your battery dies, you can just change the batteries and start filming right away. Then tip number 5 is about coming up with video ideas. So coming up with video ideas can be pretty hard, especially when you're a small YouTuber. I mean, you don't get sent all these fun products to review. It can kind of be hard to like know what do I want to film, and I even struggle with this as well. A tip that I have is start brainstorming on video ideas and just writing them all down in a notebook. So I have a YouTube notebook where I write down video ideas, like when I think of them, so that during a later time where I don't know what I want to film, I can just take that notebook and like search for a nice video idea. And in that way, like, you don't miss uploads because you don't have ideas. So next step is to write down the things you want to talk about in your video. So you can do this in the same notebook as your video ideas, or you can write them down somewhere else. But I do recommend before starting with filming your video to write down the things you want to talk about, just so your video doesn't get chaotic. So I definitely had videos where I didn't do this and I was just like sitting in front of my camera and like improvising, but then it cost so much time afterwards editing because I was just saying things all the time that weren't relevant. So that really sucked. Your video is going to be way more structured and it's going to save you a lot of time editing. And tip number 7 is to be consistent with your uploads. I've definitely struggled with quite a lot in the past. I've had times where I would upload like 2 or 3 times a week and then I wouldn't upload for like 2 months because I just didn't really know what to film, for instance, or I wasn't really motivated to film. This really had impact on my subscriber numbers and my view count, because like people were unsubscribing because I wasn't uploading, and then when I was starting to upload again, they were still unsubscribing because they were probably like, who is this girl? Why hasn't she uploaded? I'm going to unsubscribe. So last month I decided I wanted to upload 2 times a week on Sunday and Wednesday, and giving yourself such a schedule is really good, and it's just going to really help you planning so you know when to film and upload your videos. Tip number 8 is don't make your videos too long. So especially when you're first starting out, you don't really want really long videos because people are just probably not going to watch it. In your YouTube analytics, you can see like the average time that people watch your videos, and usually this is not as high as you think it is. So when you talk too much and it's not really interesting, people tend to click away your videos pretty quickly. And you want to avoid that. So instead of making your video super long, you want to be straight to the point and have a shorter video, because in this way your viewers are more likely to stick to the end of your video and don't leave during the video. So I recommend keeping them somewhere between 5 and 10 minutes. I feel like videos under 5 minutes are a little bit too short sometimes. I don't like my videos to be like 15 or 20 minutes because I feel like no one is going to watch my entire video if they're so long. You definitely want as much people to watch your video as you can. Then tip number 9 is interact with your subscribers or viewers. Sometimes I see these small YouTubers that like are trying to get more subscribers, but then the people who are actually subscribed to them or like watching their videos, they don't respond to. So how nice is it to like have a bond with your subscribers and actually be able to interact with them? So I always try to reply to like the majority of my comments, and I mean, it's normal to not be able to respond to every single comment if you get like quite a lot, but try to interact with your viewers as much as you can and reply to comments as much as you can, because this is going to really create a bond with your subscriber. And then tip number 10, the last tip of this video, is to create content that you love. So I feel like a lot of people who are starting out YouTube now want to do it because they want to be famous or they want to earn money. The thing that makes YouTube so much fun and the thing that's going to keep you going is creating content that you like and not because other people want to see it. I mean, of course, if you have subscribers, it's nice if you upload things that they want to see. Never do like a video that you would have never done if it wasn't for like the views or the subscribers. And if you don't upload videos that you love, then you might quit early or you don't like doing YouTube, because really the fun thing about YouTube is that you can share your passion and share the things that you love with your viewers. I'd rather have less subscribers and make videos that I love and I love making than having a lot of subscribers but constantly having to make videos that I don't like myself. Okay guys, and these were my 10 tips on how to start a YouTube channel. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and find it helpful. If you have any questions for starting your channel or any questions in general, you can always leave a comment, and I, like I said, try to respond to every single one of them. You can also send me a DM on Instagram if you have a question. My username is @GlamBySam with 2 M's and an X at the end. So if you did enjoy this video, then again, I would love it if you gave it a thumbs up. It would really help me. And don't forget, you can always subscribe and click the notification bell if you want to see more of my videos and be notified when I upload. So with that said, I want to thank you guys all so much for watching this video. I really hope you have an amazing day, and I really hope to see you in my next video. Bye.